Christian Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Ordinary Blessings, prayers, poems, and meditations for everyday life by Maida Herrick Carlson. Narrated by Joana Garcia. Preface. I write because I don't know what I think until I read what I say. Flannery O'Connor. I've always been an external processor, the written word able to access emotions and faith that can't find another way out. And I've always been pretty decent at a bunch of things, but not excellent at a specific thing. Imagine you're playing Go Fish. Everyone else has a few cards, and you have half the deck fanned out in front of your face. Or you're a high school letter jacket filled with honorable mention patches. That hand, that jacket, is me. A little bit of everything and happy to be in the running. These things play out in my vocations, too. I'm a parish pastor, which means I'm pretty decent at a bunch of things, like preaching good news, comforting the dying, feeding the hungry, fundraising for Jesus, and plunging toilets in a pinch. I'm a generalist, always ready to connect folks to other people who are trained experts or similarly curious. I'm a parent of three, which means I get to make the rules, write the charts, and be the boss. Actually, I'm still working toward that dictatorship model. This parenting thing is hard, and I spend most of my time reacting to their frustrating and fantastic antics. I recently broke the news to my son that I've never had an 8-year-old before, and I'm learning as I go. He responded in a deadpan tone, "I think that's pretty obvious, Mom." I'm a partner to a steady and charming person named Matt. Turns out he thinks all the ordinary, pretty decent stuff about me is spectacular. Since I'm very impressionable, I've started to think so too. And in embracing my ordinary life, I've realized how much God also delights in these things. I started writing blessings, poems, and prayers for the ordinary stuff a few years ago and realized the more I wrote, the more I needed them. It feels good and holy to notice God's attention to the regular, to consider God's investment in the little moments that matter to my daily life, to bless the pretty decent things and call them good. My prayer is that you will discover a few written words in here that help you access your emotions and faith in a new way. And since I'm no expert at this, I hope you'll join me in finding more words and ways to bless the ordinary. Blessings for everyday life. For home. I give thanks for the space thoroughly lived in, the clutter and crumbs, laundry piled high, a door to close and lock, the wily weeds woven into the lawn. I am glad for that which is mine to tend, a bookshelf and bedroom, apartment or acre. I will keep it so that my soul is well lived and examined here, gentle and enough. These walls watch me rehearse declarations that I take up space. I belong. I am here. For morning anxiety. Don't get up quite yet. First blink and breathe and believe you are fiercely loved. Do not be fooled by the list that hunts you down each dawn. You are called to a few things, not all the things. Be still until you hear the sacred silence whisper. Underneath the hustle and the bundle of nerves, that thing you are desperate to earn has already been declared. And then rise like the sun, one shade of sky at a time. For getting dressed. They are just clothes, not molds. These fabrics and styles could never fold the fullness of your bright body and personhood into a simple-sized container. So tailor and hem or thrift, knowing you are fearfully and wonderfully made for more than fitting in between pockets and seams. May you choose clothes that help you present yourself to world, free from fear or shame, wrapping you in sturdy confidence and personal flair that celebrate whoever you wish to be on this particular day. For the bus stop. Strangers check the schedule, post up, watching the street lights turn, fishing out passes and exact change from the basements of purses or pockets. The weather pushes proximity closer together under the shelter. There are places to be, but first, this place, together. God's spirit is in the gathering, the waiting, the recognition of others going somewhere too. And so, the young man loads his bike quickly before coming alongside an old woman, offering his arm while a neighbor folds up her walker. Only then can we start getting where we're all going. For your car. This vehicle grants freedom, safe passage, an independent schedule, a carriage of guidance from here to there. It can feel like bondage, waiting for maintenance, hearing the cost of a part that sounds made up. Shift gears back to freedom with a prayer. For those who do not have this luxury, for those who cannot afford repairs or fuel, for those who do not have reliable transportation, for those who depend on their car for shelter. Protection for those who travel, those who teach new drivers, those who build and repair vehicles, those who produce clean energy, those who maintain bridges and roads. Safety and gratitude for every mile crossed, for each coming and going, for those we pass on the way. For walking through doors. Before you pass through, stop long enough to hear your hopes for the other side. You cannot know for sure just yet which paints this portico in adventure. It's the unknowable that makes it wild. For cooking a meal. It is an act of holy resistance each time you choose ingredients, considering where they came from and how they found you. Of all the chefs in all the world. Turn on the music and make a mess. Have a good cry until the whole onion is diced. Read the recipe aloud and slowly becoming family with all who have aimed for this meal. You will soon dine with them, connected by the good mystery of dinner. For mealtimes. For breakfast. May this morning meal nourish me with gratitude, strength, and health for today. For lunch, may this midday meal be reason to pause my work and offer thanks for food that sustains and delights. For dinner, may this evening meal provide time to reflect on the goodness I receive and those who need mine. For brunch, may this feast flavor our conversation with kindness and courage that become a blessing to others. For dessert, may the richness of this food be met with an abundance of spirit and an indulgent and open heart. For grocery shopping, there is extravagant choice breaking through this mundane task. The continents have gathered variety, color, texture, flavor, eager to please and displayed with pride by the labor of a few who sustain us all. What magic to choose, with senses unleashed, so stomachs are filled and abundance is known inside and out. Select with duty and joy. Hold the food, giving thanks for the hands and the earth, decorating gratitude with the divine reason. This abundance is meant for the whole world. for paying bills. These piles of paper, packets of jargon, stale signs of responsibility are too often condensed into heavy, salty numbers, causing anxiety and fear. But they are also piles of memories, packets of services, fresh symbols of joy, and lessons learned. Their true power is hidden not in fine print, but in a spiritual language of oppression and freedom. These documents tell stories about generations of policies created by some for all, the disparity of those ignored and those rewarded for ignoring. Each application and payment, a political action, a testament to comfort and control, values and grit.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.